They call him the Trump of the tropics. Brazil's Jair Bolsonaro, president, secured a huge victory in 2018, winning his election with more than 55% of the vote in a deeply polarized nation. And indeed, Bolsonaro and Trump became fast friends, even dining together at Trump's Mar-a-Lago resort. Bolsonaro's campaign echoed Trump's own run in 2016. He had his own drain-the-swamp take on fighting crime and corruption, controversial views, to say the least, on women and the LGBT community, deep support for and from Brazil's military. But since his inauguration in 2019, Bolsonaro has faced and at times created one huge fire after another. First, the economy. Brazil still feeling the impact of its worst ever recession, which began in 2014. Bolsonaro promised to turn that around, but economic growth in Brazil remains low and unemployment very high. Then you've got actual fires raging in the Amazon during Brazil's dry season. Rapid deforestation accounts for 1/3 of the destruction of the world's tropical forest in 2019 alone. President Trump was willing to look the other way on this environmental tragedy. He was kind of a climate skeptic himself, but the Biden administration, not so much. And finally, the COVID pandemic. Bolsonaro's handling of the biggest public health crisis of our lifetimes has been disastrous, one of the world's worst. He downplayed the severity, refused to support mask wearing, mishandled the vaccine rollout. As the pandemic took hold, Bolsonaro offered an emergency stipend in Brazil that temporarily helped the country's poorest citizens, but 55% of the Brazilian population faced food insecurity in 2020. About twice as many Brazilians went hungry last year than the number in 2018, before Bolsonaro was elected, and hunger remains a huge problem. Bolsonaro is up for re-election next year, and it's going to be an incredibly interesting and divisive campaign. The likely challenger is Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva. Just call him Lula. Everyone else does. He's as far left as Bolsonaro is right. Bolsonaro got elected in 2018 as an alternative to 14 years of rule by Lula's Workers' Party. Now, Bolsonaro will be able to run against Lula directly. Will the Trump of the tropics see his political fortunes cool down? It's hard to say, because this is where the whole Trump-Bolsonaro comparison comes to a screeching halt. The United States has a two-party system. Brazil has around 24 political parties, making consensus building for both candidates far more complicated. How does Brazil recover from this devastating pandemic, and what's on the political horizon in 2022?